This video shows how to set up and run the optimization experiment, which can be used to improve the system's performance by making decisions about the system's parameters or structure. We'll use the oil terminal example model, which comprises the following main parts: railroad platforms for receiving and discharging oil products, tanks for storing oil products, tankers for shipping oil products. The model's main agent has the following parameters that can be varied during simulation: train's inter-arrival time, number of tanks in tanker, tanker tank capacity, and train capacity. Let's use the optimization experiment to determine the values of the parameters that will result in the maximum total amount of exported oil products. First, we need to define an expression that will obtain this total value. The exported amount of each oil product, petrol, diesel fuel, fuel oil, and crude oil, is calculated with the help of the corresponding output element. Add the function element from the agent palette onto the main diagram. Name it products exported total and set it to return a value. In the function body field, type return petrol export plus diesel fuel export plus fuel oil export plus crude oil export. When called, this function will return the sum of the output's values. As part of the experiment, we'll also ensure that trains do not stack up waiting in a queue before being discharged. Each train belongs to the train's population, which has several statistics, which can be obtained by calling the corresponding function of a population. Specifically, the queue statistics will return a single value, which is the number of trains currently waiting in a queue. For our experiment, however, we need to obtain the average number of lined up trains throughout the entire simulation time frame, which can be achieved with the help of the statistics element. Drag the statistics element from the analysis palette onto the main diagram and name it trains queue. In the value field, type trains.queue to obtain the value returned by the queue statistics of the train's population. This element will periodically update its data to allow us to calculate the average number of trains. Finally, we can create the optimization experiment. In the projects tree, right-click any model item and select New Experiment. Choose the optimization experiment type and click Finish. Once the newly created experiment appears in the projects tree, we can start setting it up. First, define the objective function. In order to maximize the total exported amount, choose Maximize and provide the call to root.productsExportedTotal. Here, root is used to refer to main, the experiment's top-level agent, which contains the products exported total function. The optimization experiment execution process consists of multiple simulation experiment runs. Leave the proposed number of iterations unchanged. Additionally, enable automatic stop, which will make the optimization engine stop the experiment automatically as soon as the objective function value stops improving. Now, we need to define the boundaries within which the parameters are varied. Let us assume that tankers of a single type and capacity are serviced at the terminal. Leave the tanker's tank capacity and the number of tanks in a tanker parameters as fixed so that they're not varied during optimization. The train's inter-arrival time and the capacity of the train, which is the incoming amount of oil products, will be varied during optimization. Set the train's inter-arrival time parameter to continuous and define the boundaries as 120 minutes or 2 hours and 600 minutes or 10 hours. Set the train capacity parameter to discrete and define the boundaries as 400 and 1,000 cubic meters respectively. Set the step to 50, which should approximately correspond to the capacity of a single tank rail car. Next, set the simulation stop time. In the model time section, select stop at specified time and set stop time to 120 hours, which corresponds to 5 model days. Since our model includes multiple stochastic elements, a single simulation run may be non-representative. Therefore, we need to run the simulation several times for each set of parameter values. This can be done with the help of replications. In the randomness section, select random seed to make each simulation run uniquely. In the replications section, select the Use Replications checkbox and set the number of replications per iteration to 10. To impose additional restriction on the solution found by the optimization engine, define a requirement, which is checked at the end of each simulation. If the requirement is not met, the corresponding set of parameter values is rejected. Let's create a requirement stating that trains are not allowed to be lined up. In the Requirements section, click the Add button to add a new requirement. In the Expression field, type root.trainsQ.mean to obtain the average number stored in the train's queue statistics element. Leave the type value unchanged and set bound to 0 so that the resulting condition is less than or equal to 0. The optimization experiment diagram is currently empty. Since the experiment is now fully set up, we can click the Create Default UI button to create the optimization experiment user interface. We are now ready to start the experiment. The chart displays the obtained values of the objective function. The blue line represents feasible solutions. The red line represents the infeasible solution, for which the no-queued trains requirement is not met. The engine uses its internal heuristic algorithm to pick the set of parameter values for the successive run. After completing the required number of runs, the engine comes up with a set of parameter values producing the optimal objective value. The optimization process is over. Click the Copy button to copy the obtained values of the parameters to the clipboard. In the Simulation Experiment Properties, click the Paste from Clipboard button to replace the default values with the copied ones. If we run the simulation experiment again, it will consider the found optimal values, and the total amount of exported oil products will therefore be maximized. Thanks for watching. Come back for more AnyLogic how-to videos.